Everything that we see and feel around us is termed as matter. Even though that matter is classified into three major states. And what are these three states of matter? That's right, they are solid, liquid and gas. Thought what the matter around us could be made up of? Well, this question is not new and has been addressed a long time ago. And many people had made an attempt to answer it. Let us have a look a few of philosophies and theories. Recorded evidences suggest that around 500 BC, Indian philosopher Maharishi Kannad hypothesized a concept. His curiosity about components of matter made him put for an idea. He suggested, when we divide matter into tinier particles, ultimately we reach a state when the matter cannot be divided further. These particles which cannot be divided further make up the matter. The matter was called Padarth in Indian language and he named the particles as Parmanu. Similar lines, another Indian philosopher named Pakuda Kathayama made slight modifications in Maharishi Kannad's work and elaborated saying that such indivisible particles come in different combinations to make up different kinds of matter. Around the same era, two Greek philosophers also suggested the same concept. Personalities were Democritus and Leucippus. They also postulated if we divide matter continuously, then we reach a state where it cannot be divided further. These indivisible particles thus make a complete matter. Democritus named these particles as atoms, being indivisible.
Around the end of the 18th century, a few scientists could prove the suggestions correct. They not only discovered, researched about atoms, but also threw light on the basic difference between elements and compounds. Yes, studying this way, the way for many scientists to understand how several combinations lead to different substances. But when I say combinations, it means we will have chemical reactions, right? Yes, that's correct. And chemical reactions is governed by some important laws. This fact was understood and accepted widely when foundation of chemical sciences, when led by the French nobleman and chemist, Antoine Lavoisier. Then the two most important laws of chemical combinations were established. They were popularly known as law of conservation of mass and law of constant proportions.
Antoine Lavoisier put forth the law of conservation of mass. And do you know what it tells us? It states that mass can neither be created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. He explained this law by saying that matter is formed from the pre-existing matter and the mass of the newly formed matter will be the same as that of the pre-existing matter. We can neither create new matter nor destroy the existing matter. Now we need to take a look at the second law, which is law of constant proportions or the law of definite proportions. They are the same thing. The law was first put forth in the year 1797 by a French chemist called Joseph Proust, and hence it also referred to as a Proust's law. What does the law state? The law states that in a chemical substance, elements are always in a fixed proportion by mass. But when these laws were put forth in the form of theories, proving them was quite a concern. All these explanations that we know now are due to experiments performed for many decades. Several scientists came up with many experiments and explanations. Among all, a notable theory by the name Dalton's atomic theory surfaced as an answer to many of these questions. The theory was put forth by the English chemist and physicist John Dalton.